It was just like, do you want to take that choice? If he goes sleep deeper in the coma, there's no way we could ever bring him back. And if there is a chance that he comes back, he's going to be a fucking vegetable for the rest of his life.
Yeah.
You have to go through all that bullshit. My mom, being the wise person that she is, was like, well, fuck it. You never know. Give him the shot, you know, whatever it was.
Right.
And so it put him deeper in the coma. And that's when they were like, he has 24 hours left. He's fucking dying. When he was in that 24-hour coma, he suffered 2 heart attacks, and he had a stroke.
Now,
it was fucking terrible, man. Terrible. So, sorry, my foot's falling asleep. So, basically, what happened was, he lasted 8 days. Like, my dad was a fit guy. Like, he...
Yeah, doing the work he does.
Well, he was very athletic. He loved playing fucking baseball. He never played soccer, but he loved having his kids play soccer. I was in a... 2 different soccer leagues, both championship teams, not to boast or anything, cause I couldn't fucking do it to save my life. You know, I'd be like, ball! Oh, Jesus, I kicked it over here. It's supposed to go over here.
Oh, butterfly!
Yeah, like, fucking ladybugs! Yes! I get it! Yes! Awesome.
High five.
Yeah! Reference. There's going to be a lot of those, trust me. But yeah, so like, he's very athletic, very fit. You know, he really took care of himself.
He lasted fucking 8 days.
And he lasted 8 days after the doctors gave him 24 hours. And even the doctors were like, I don't fucking know what's going on. Like, this is kind of a miracle, but he's not coming out, but he's still surviving. So finally it came down to he's fucking dying because he had another heart attack, so he had 3 total. And he suffered so much brain damage and, you know, nerve loss, and, like, he was fucking done.
Yeah.
He was just literally laying there being kept alive by a machine. So without sounding mean or cruel or anything, my mom killed him.
No, she pulled the plug.
She pulled the plug and
say
killed
that.
Him. And killed him.
And he passed on.
And he passed on. We buried...
Euphemisms all around.
Like I said, I don't mean in a bad way. I love my mom.
No, that's fine.
But it's the truth. She fucking pulled the plug and my dad died.
That's hard, though.
What? I was 7. I didn't
No. I'm saying that's
for her?
For your fucking mom.
Well,
fuck
what?
You, turtle.
Yeah,
fuck your
me.
Mom.
I have
Come
no
on.
Feelings.
He doesn't.
Well,
look
my
at
mom,
him.
Well, my mom suffered really fucking hard, man. Like, really fucking... Because she didn't have a... She basically... took care of the kids. She was a stay-at-home mom.
Yeah.
And as soon as my dad died, she was like, I don't know what the fuck I'm going to do. And that's when my brother came back from living there. Because he's my half-brother.
Yeah.
So if you ever see my brother, which I'm one of you guys.
Half-Uncle Turtle.
Yeah. Well, no, you look at him like, that's your brother, because he's white. Well, I'm Mexican. Can't tell. Pale. But my brother's white. You look at him, you're like, that's your fucking brother? Like, yes, that's my brother. How? He's a goofy white dude. You're a dirty-ass Mexican. I'm like... He's half Mexican. Fuck you. You know.
Do you like the thing I said to you? It's Beaner.
Beaner. I did. It was a stereotyping Mexican by Carlos Mencia. Beaners. LOL.
It was great.
I'm
making light of a heavy subject.
No, I totally. It's not even that. But like,
it's all your fault.
It's whatever. This is just general conversation. That's what this is supposed to be. But you know, to wrap up the story, like my mom suffered really hard fucking time. She had 2 strokes herself, like the left side of her face was really fucking paralyzed.
Whoa.
And it's kind of a bittersweet thing because my mom literally went crazy. Like all the weird diseases and disorders that she had, like, came out all at once. So she had mad ADD, she had mad OCD, she had fucking high blood pressure, she suffered 2 strokes. She literally, after her stroke, she literally locked herself in her room for, I'd say, like about 6 months. Now you got to keep in mind, this is me and my sister. I'm 7, she's 9.
Yeah.
She my mom did not come out of that room for 6 months. Like, she would fucking starve herself and just all kinds of bad shit.
Yeah.
And so, like, we had to fend for ourselves. And so, not to say my mom is bad, but she kind of didn't know how to handle that big of a loss.
It's so unexpected. Like, you can't prepare for something like that.
And see, here's the thing.
And then you can't quite have the mechanisms to cope with it.
Yeah, yeah.
Either,
so,
you know?
Like, what I think is great about it is before my dad died, my mom would teach us how to cook, clean. Like, you know, I mentioned I've known how to do my laundry since I was, like, 6, 7 years old, which I'm very fucking proud to. I know guys to this day are like, I don't know how to do laundry. That's
take it to grandma's.
Yeah,
house.
That's for women. And I'm just like, how can you be a dick,
that's
dude?
That's kind of filthy too, because you know, those are the same guys who are like, I'm just gonna throw this underwear out. It stopped, you know, molding to my body.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's just one of those things where, like, I'm kind of glad my mom taught us all that. Basically, how to survive in case anything ever happened. Obviously, something really bad happened.
Mm-hmm.
But my mom, like, kind of shut herself away. And when she came back out of her weird funk, she was, like, fucking crazy, man. Like, we literally would wake up and our furniture would be rearranged. Because she had so bad a fucking OCD. We'd wake up at 3 a.m. because she's on her fucking hands and knees scrubbing the floor and shit. She wasn't on drugs,
but she just could not focus her mind.
And I think she wanted to, in a weird way, kind of get rid of what happened. Like, yeah, this didn't happen. I'm cleaning away the floor. It's like, you're fucking crazy, lady.
Mm.
And like, to this day, I call my mom lady. I don't call her mom. Everyone's like, why do you call her lady? I'm like, it's your fucking lady, man. What's up, lady?
Step inside my Gloria? Hyundai.
Ow.
I want to get with you with a fresh pack of gum. Okay, sorry. This is the thing. Just that you talk with Claire. It's going to be a movie.
But yeah, that's what's great about it. But yeah, so like basically, you know, a lot of bad shit. So that's kind of the story that happened with the wallet.
The dead man's wallet.
And you know, my biggest pet peeve, especially through my teenagers, when, you know, people like, I heard my dad, I'm sorry. This motherfucker happened so long ago. It doesn't bother me. It really, really doesn't. And, you know, like, I fit,
at the
like,
father-son dances, he had no one to dance with. But...
No.
No.
But, I mean, but, see, and, but, like, I do feel the effects of not, you know, growing up with a dad and shit because...
Oh, we all feel the effects, of you not growing up with a dad.
Fuck, I bitch about a lot of things. Well, basically what it comes down to is I don't have that basic mechanism in my life to deal with relationships. Like, I can have friends. I have plenty of friends. I have great friends. I have you guys. You guys are great friends. You know, Conrad's a great friend. My buddy Bo and Jake and Ben, they're all good friends.
Yeah.
But when it goes to having, like, a relationship, I don't know what the fuck to do because I kind of was never taught. I had to figure this shit out on my own. So I have this idea of what it's supposed to be, and obviously it's wrong. I don't have anybody. I'm still fucking single and shit. And the people I do meet who either take an interest in me or I take an interest in them, one of two things happens. They either get creeped out by me because I smother them, which I've stopped that. I've learned my lesson really fucking hard way. It fucking sucked, man. That was the worst fucking, like, summer year of my life.
Someone's coming.
Oh, my God.
Quick! Buckers, over!
No, yeah. It's not even over. How much time do we have?
It's honky. The janitor.
We got a half hour still?
Really? Whoa.
Oh, we still haven't even touched base on half the show.
I know. You want to hear my dead person story?
Yeah, sure.
All right. Okay, so.
All right, dead people, yeah!
Yeah! Well, this is actually also a story of how, I'll just get to it. So when I started my freshman year of college, I was in New Jersey, and God knows why. It was actually like I really wanted to go to NYU, and couldn't afford it. Like, fine, you can afford. Hey, you get, you know, the tuition bill, and then you also like cost of living. What? And you know, so it was like,
I have to pay to live? It's absurd.
$10 for a box of cereal?
Fuck. Oh,
and it doesn't even cure syphilis? Fuck that!
Ocular herpes?
Yes!
I'm a fan of ocular herpes. Or as I call it, baking bread on your eyes.
So, door number two, New Jersey! And so I went there, and it was pretty cool. It was actually a lot of fun. I know, that's the first on-record mention of cool.
What part of New Jersey?
It was in northern New Jersey. So I was like right outside Manhattan, and I would go in there all the time and visit friends and stuff. They had it so much better than me. But, So while I was up there, my favorite grandmother died. And I was really sad because it was like she had a long bout with cancer. And it was one of those things where I was like, cancer? This is like science cured that shit, you know? Come on, people like live. There's all sorts of cancer survivors walking around with pink ribbons and shit on. And it's no big deal. I got, you know, bigger fish to fry. Like, what dorm do I party in tonight, you know? And like,
yeah!
Stuff like that, but it was really hard on me, and she was just wonderful. She was like one of those, she was this very cosmopolitan kind of grandma. Like, she didn't cook. I never had a grandma that cooked, you know. You never go over and like, I got a pie in the oven. It was like, I got Sara Lee in the freezer in the garage, you know.
You
go
see this? That's because of my family. That's because
No, but
my
it's
family.
Good food. It's homemade food, and she had like, you know, TV dinners, which were exciting, kind of. And
to a point.
Sometimes, whatever. And she traveled a lot, and we had all these big plans to go to Ireland and retrace our family roots and stuff. And she was gorgeous. She was one of those grandmas. She had